Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to insert data inside a collection in MongoDB database. So let's get started. So first let me open my command prompt and MongoDB shell. So just go to search and type cmd, and you need to open your command prompt. And for getting a MongoDB shell, you need to type the command mongo or mongosh depending upon your version. So in some cases it will be mongo, and in some cases it's going to be mongosh. So I'll just type mongosh and I'll be getting my MongoDB shell. So for displaying the list of databases that are present inside our MongoDB, we need to use the command show dbs and hit enter. So these are the databases that are present inside my MongoDB, and here you can see right admin, config, local and new DB. So this is basically MongoDB compass, just a visualization tool of our MongoDB shell. All right. So first let's begin with by creating a database and a collection, and after that let's see how we can insert values. So for creating a database, it's going to be use. Let me go with second DB, something like that. And I'll just hit enter. So I'll be having switched to second DB. And only after creating a collection, we will be able to see our database listed over here. So let's just create a collection. So for creating a collection, it's going to be DB dot create capital C collection. And within double quotes, you need to name your collection or table name basically. So I'll just go with new table and hit enter. So if we get the result as OK1, it means that our collection has been successfully created. So if I go to my MongoDB compass now, and if I just now click on this refresh databases button, we'll be getting our second DB over here. And if I just now open it, we'll be having our new table collection, and this is now empty because we don't have any values. We didn't insert any values yet. So now let's see how we can insert some values inside our collection or table. So for inserting data, it's obvious we will be using the insert function. So it's going to be db dot our collection or table name. In my case, my collection name is new table. So it's going to be db dot new table and dot insert open circular bracket, and inside the circular bracket put a curly bracket. All right, curly bracket, and inside this we need to specify our key and value pairs. So the key shouldn't contain any double quotes or single quote, only our value, especially string, should contain double quotes. So let me just now show you. So first let me go with roll number key, and this shouldn't have any quotes. And since number is going to be of type integer, let's just directly specify 100 without any quotes, okay, and just put a comma. And let me go with name colon, and since name is going to be of type string, we need to put double quotes. So I'll just go with John. So this is how it works, guys. The key that we are specifying over here shouldn't have any quotes, and if it's of type integer, no quotes also. And if the value is of type string, we need to have quotes, and it should be inside curly bracket enclosed by circular bracket of the insert function. So I'll just hit enter. Okay, now it says collection.insert is deprecated. I know many of you would be using collection.insert, but here it asks us to replace with insert one. So we need to press the up arrow key, okay? Up arrow key. We will be getting the exact same command over here, and just change this insert to insert one. That's it, with a capital O. And if I just now hit enter, so now you can see I'm not getting this warning. But this function will also work. Insert will also work, and insert one will also work. But the only thing is that insert is deprecated. Try using insert one, but this is also working currently. So if I just go to my MongoDB collection, and here you can see that I'm having two values. So if you aren't able to see any values, you need to just click on this refresh documents. You need to refresh this. I'll be having this two values inserted because we have run two comments over here. And now in case if you want to insert multiple documents, by documents I mean rows. So in case if you want to insert multiple things, you can use the insert many function over here. So for this, it's exactly the same command. I will just change this insert one to insert many. The syntax is exactly the same. And here inside the circular bracket, we'll be having square bracket. At first, we'll be having a square bracket, and inside that, each of our data or values will be separated by curly bracket. So I hope you're here, you can see, right? It's going to be circular bracket and a square bracket. And within that, we will be having our key and value pair of a single row. So consider this as a row or object, and just put a comma, and I will just again put a curly bracket, and I will go with the same roll number. So this is basically how it looks. We will be having circular bracket and a square bracket over here. Within that, we'll be having our objects or rows. All right, exactly the same format, but here we are inserting multiple things rather than running this insert one command many times. So if I just now hit enter, so here we'll be having 0, 1, 2, and if I just go to my compass and if I refresh it, we will be having five records, I guess, because here we have inserted three more. Refresh this. So here you can see, right, I'll be having five in total. So this is basically how insert works, guys, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.